Last week, Airtable updated some amazing new features inside of their platform. They came at us with a lot of news. Some things are currently live and some we have to wait for just a little bit longer. But if you're interested in knowing what these upcoming changes are, including the ones that are present today, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we help you automate the bullshit. We do that using no-code tools, and Airtable has always been at the forefront of those tools that we use, and they unlocked some amazing new features that we have got to talk about here today. But before we get into it, if you're not already leveraging automation to take away those repetitive tasks that you do over and over again, I have a free training that is going to help you get there quickly, and we're going to unlock all the fundamentals of building automation in no code. Doesn't matter what tool you use to do this in no code, they all work the same. So grab that training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration so that you can start saving time and focusing on the big picture instead of doing the same repetitive tasks day in, day out. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this. We've got to talk about the new features that Airtable has leaked for us in their latest press release. Really cool stuff. And as I mentioned, some of these things are already live and we're going to have to take a look at them here today. So let's go ahead and pop on into it. First things first, let's check out this blog post that came out on October 12th. And they are introducing this new idea that they're calling Airtable Connected Apps Platform. So what is that? Well, I'm not going to read the whole blog here for you, but you can check out the Connected Apps Platform hyperlink inside of the blog. So let's zoom in on this chunk right here. A Connected Apps Platform is a single platform that allows anyone in an organization to easily build and customize apps using real-time shared company data. When you seamlessly connect everyone and everything, anything is possible. So this is the core idea behind building connected apps inside of Airtable. And a lot of us have been doing this for some time already, but the key takeaway here is that Airtable is leaning into this concept and allowing people, especially in larger organizations, to spread that information out and really put the power of the developer in the hands of everyone so that on any department, you can share information that is core to the functionality of the overall business, and you can have these spin-off fractions that help you in your particular department or in your particular role within the organization. Let's flip back into the original blog post and scroll on down. I welcome you to check out the video that Airtable's already put out themselves. But here we go, creating a network of connected apps in your organization. New features including verified data. So they're saying that we can publish and surface key data so that everyone can build apps with the same accurate information. Verified data is currently in development and will be available in early 2023. So how cool is this, right? Having the ability to share verified data across your organization so that people are all working from the same source of truth. This was one of those buzzwords that I heard a lot of in the past week as these new features were unlocked. So verified data is going to be a big one that I'm looking forward to. Next, we're going into the data map feature. Visualize connections between data points so that you can build, manage, and scale work. The data map is currently in development and will also be ready in early 2023. So far, these two, not available yet, but cool stuff coming down the pipe. Next, we're looking at two-way sync. Automatically update data across multiple apps to ensure information is correct. I don't know how I can stress enough how excited I am for two-way sync. This is something we have wanted ever since Airtable unlocked the ability to sync tables. If you're currently using a synced table in your Airtable structure, well, you probably know that it's a one-way sync. You have a parent and a child relationship, and it's basically a mirror image that's coming from the parent, and you can read it in the child version, but you can't actually edit it. Two-way sync is going to get rid of all of that. So we can edit data in either source, and it's going to be synced back across so that we have that single source of truth, regardless of where we're editing the data. This is mind-blowing. Going on to read what the rest of this is, two-way sync is currently in limited availability for enterprise customers and will be more broadly available in 2023. So again, probably unlocked for the pro plans, maybe the plus plans as well. We'll have to see. But they're saying that don't look for this until early 2023 unless you're one of those enterprise clients who's already using it. Next, let's go into Interface Designer, and this is where things get exciting. Obviously, we've had Interface Designer for a while, but this quick blurb says, transform your data into intuitive and interactive interfaces that can be quickly customized for each team member. Yes, we've had that before. Interface Designer is now generally available for all Airtable users with updated and more powerful features. And that's the key right here. All Airtable users, they are not cutting this out for specific tiers. Presumably, anyone who uses Airtable is going to have full control over this new Interface Designer, including all these new features. We're going to have to take a look at those new features coming up after I get through this list. But before we get there, let's talk about permissions. Ensuring the right people have access to the right info. Easily control access to your app by granting permissions to the entire app, just the interface, or even just information relevant to the user. Granular interface permissions are now available for Pro and Enterprise customers. This is next level. This, in many cases, eliminates the need for some of the rudimentary portals that we may have been building in third-party tools, allowing us now instead to build an interface, share granular permissions just to that interface without sharing access to the underlying data structure or the rest of the app in general. This is going to be a really cool feature, again, currently available for Pro and Enterprise plans, and we're definitely going to check this out in the upcoming section of this video as well. Next, we have Apps by Airtable. Get started faster with apps that can be used straight out of the box, each being custom built for an essential use case and based on industry best practices. The first set of apps are going to be available in early 2023. So what is the difference between an app and a base? And we've had a library of Airtable templates forever now, so why would you care so much about Apps by Airtable? Well, because of the fact that apps encompass the entire thing. So the templates that we get access to in the Airtable's templates library, they are just the data structure. If you're lucky, it might have an automation built in there. There may be a very preliminary interface in there, but for the most part, the templates in the library came into existence before we had automations and before we had interfaces. So it really was just the schema, the Airtable data structure that is available in the templates library. And that's the key concept behind apps. Apps, it's the whole kit and caboodle. We've got the data structure, the data schema in your database. You also have the ability to build your automations. That's part of the app. And you have the interfaces themselves, how people are going to interact with the underlying data that lives in that app. Well, all of that is part of the app. So Apps by Airtable encompasses the whole kit and caboodle, all of those three key features. And so when we now install an app in Airtable, it is going to be the full thing. And that's really exciting, especially because, as Airtable has said, they are going to be focusing on industry best practices so you can get up and running that much more quickly inside of Airtable, thanks to Airtable apps. Now, let's talk about the redesigned home screen. If you don't yet have access to this, you're gonna see it on my screen in just a second. But basically, they're saying, look, with the new home screen, discover and access the apps your organization relies on. Right from the new home screen, enterprise customers can opt into the home screen today, and it will be rolled out to all users over the next few months. So if you're looking forward to it, it's coming your way pretty soon. Just stay tuned. So let's go ahead and pop into my Airtable screen now. And here inside of Airtable, you're getting a first glimpse, maybe, of that new home screen design. Pretty slick stuff. I'm going to go ahead and scroll on down to my hourly consultations base, and we're going to pop that open and take a quick look at this. So this is a test base that I've been setting up over the last couple of weeks just to kind of test out some of the new features as they've been rolling out. And so it's not really functional, but I do have an interface built for it already. So I can click into that interface and go take a look at this. The first thing you'll notice is that I get this pop-up of what's new in Interface Designer. So these are live changes. Again, I'm on a Pro plan right here, but anybody on Pro or Enterprise is supposed to have access to these features already today. So first one, share your interface without sharing your base. I'll show you exactly how to do that, but this allows you to customize permissions to share only what matters to your team. Moving on down from that, we've got choose which record details your users can see, meaning that you can show or hide fields to set the layout that works best inside Interface Designer. So imagine that. Now we can share access to our interface and only allow people to see specific fields based on what we want them to see. So this is something that's been missing for a long time. Previously, when you shared access to your interface designer, then you were also sharing access to the underlying data structure, which of course meant that you had no control over the data inside your database, because ultimately, once you shared a designer, then that meant that, hey, if you have access to interface, you have access to everything. But no longer, now you can share just that interface, and again, I'll show you exactly how. We can also move between pages with easier navigation, so give users faster access to pages in the interface. And then lastly, configure elements on a cleaner canvas. Adjust data and appearance settings without blocking your elements. So lots to unpack here. The features I'm most excited about and that I want to showcase here are the ones that are actually going to change how you use Interface Designer. Specifically, faster navigation because of moving between pages. Also the ability to choose what details users see, and then also sharing interface without sharing the base. Awesome features. Let's go move on into it. First things first, you see that I can create a new page in the upper right corner of my interface. This is a single page interface, so no navigation here. But if I were to, let's say, duplicate this particular page, I can just come down here. And again, it's saying, where do you want to duplicate it? So bear in mind that a page doesn't have to be duplicated inside of the same interface. In this case, I want it to be. So I'll duplicate it here. And now I have two copies of that exact same page. And now you can see at the top of my screen that I can quickly and easily navigate between those two pages inside of the same interface. Alternatively, I can click on the interface here, add it to my starred features, or just return to interfaces in general. So improved navigation all around. Let me go ahead and quickly publish these changes, just so that we can see what the live version of this looks like. Once that's done publishing, it asks me who I want to share it with. I'm not going to get to that just yet. We'll return to that in a second. And you can see that all I need to do is click between these two things, and there it is. I'm able to switch between these two. Now, they are practically identical because I duplicated them, so not much to see here, but I'm sure you can imagine how much more quickly this is going to allow you to navigate between pages inside of your interface designer. Now let's take a look at the sharing module. When I pop this open, yes, I can share by link, but you'll notice that I'm sharing the interface. And let's go ahead and I'll type in a fake email here. Let's say I was adding my assistant here to this particular interface. You'll notice that I have the option to allow them access to data in the hourly consultations base. So this is the big one here. I am no longer by default giving them access to the data structure as well. To the database in particular. In this case, if I leave it unchecked, this person's only gonna get access to the interface, which again is a game changer because I get full control over what shows up on the interface. So now I can share stuff that's in Airtable without sharing everything. And we've been waiting for this since I started talking about Airtable 5 years ago. Very, very cool feature. You can also choose to notify this person if you gave them access or not, add a message. We've been able to do this for a while. But note that they can't be a creator in this particular interface. I can only share editor, commenter, or read only from this particular screen. So once you're good with that, click the invite button. Now this individual or this team, whoever you're sharing with, is only going to be able to see the stuff in the interface and not the underlying data. This is massive. Let's go back into an interface one more time into the edit function of interface. Here I am in the copy that I built earlier, and if I want to add new elements, just come on down to the bottom and we can see all the different things that we can bring in here. From here, I will select the grid view and go ahead and drop that in here. What I want to bring to your attention is on the right-hand side of the screen here. I have the consultant grid. I can actually just change it to a gallery, a timeline, a calendar, or a Kanban right here with just a click of a few buttons. I'm going to settle on grid. I can also drill into the appearance, change the row height, and add color to the records based on conditions, just as I can back in the base, in the data structure itself. So this is really exciting, I think, to bring this into interfaces. Going back to the data itself, we can choose whether they are getting to view this or if they have editable permissions here. And then we can also drill into the linked record permissions. So do they see all records? And do they see all records here as well? This is one of the places that we can hide the information that shows up in the interface. For example, if we had somebody logged into this interface that didn't have access to the underlying data structure, and we say, actually, you know, I don't want you to see all of the payables, well, then maybe we just say you only get access to specific records, and we can set up some conditions, some filters as to what they're allowed to see inside of this interface. And this way, we're able to keep a lot more control over what people see when they're expanding data. So going back now to the data itself, you'll also see that we have options here, and I can choose what fields I want to show inside of this grid view. I can hide them all. Immediately, they're all removed except for the primary field, the leftmost field. Let's go ahead and bring in the user and the personal schedule link, and we'll also bring in cancellations, let's say. And I can sort this information, I can group this information, but all of this is happening right here inside of the interface designer. Now, one last piece that you'll definitely want to explore on your own is bringing in a filter, and we can bring in all records, or say the viewer's records only, or specific records that meet conditions. And again, this is where we can cut down on what people see. Limit it to just the stuff that makes sense for that particular user, and this is going to make working in your interfaces a lot more seamless and give you a lot more control over who sees what within the organization. I know there's a lot to unpack with these new features, and I definitely went fast because there's just so much to cover. I hope you get a chance to take this out for yourself and take it out for a spin. Let me know in the comments below what you think about these new features and what you're looking forward to with the upcoming features in early 2023. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to this channel so that you can stay on top of no-code and no-code news, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.